views and opinions expressed in this program are those of the participants and do not necessarily reflect the views of Bronxnet or the program underwriters.
And good morning, everybody, and welcome to Open, the one and only show that opens up the Bronx and the world to you. I'm your host, the Dr. Bob Lee from 107.5 WBLS, and right here, Channel 67's Open. We got a great show lined up for you today. Coming up on today's show, we'll learn about joint health and with one organization working to spread awareness and health. And plus, we'll preview an event designed to help you change your destiny and end violence. After that, we'll take a look at a program working to help our youth strive through greatness, through art and music. Then the African American Day Parade celebrates 47 years in Harlem, and we'll get a taste of this day filled with culture, unity, fun, and a whole lot more. Then later on, we'll find out about what one store is doing for Mosaic Preparatory. It's the Mosaic Preparatory Academy, and the school year approaches. They're going to let us know more about what they're doing, so stay tuned. All this and more is headed your way because we are now open. I'm your host, Dr. Bob Lee, and you're watching Open, the only live interactive program that brings the Bronx and New York City straight to your TV set. We want to encourage you to stay connected to us. You can tweet us at Bronxnet TV and follow us on Facebook at Open Bronxnet Television. Leading off the show, our first guest is an arthritis researcher for creaky joints. Sometimes it happens to you, right? You can hear it. Also does research for a Global Healthy Living Foundation. And joining us for a look at his work and to spread information about health, we welcome Ben Noel to the show. Ben, great. We welcome you.
Thanks, Bob. It's great to be here on Open.
Yes. And we heard a lot about some of the work that you do, your research and everything. Tell us first, tell us about what you do.
Sure. Happy to. First of all, I feel, Bob, like I need to drop my voice a couple registers down to match yours. It's great to be with someone that with a radio personality voice. So I manage all of our research activities with Creaky Joints and the Global Healthy Living Foundation. Mm-hmm. And specifically, I manage all of our patient-centered research. What that means is it's the kind of research that engages patients not just as passive human subjects or participants in research, but people who really get to participate in the design, the implementation, and the dissemination or the spreading the results, learning about the information that we learn from arthritis research. Creaky Joints is an amazing community. It's a go-to source for more than 100,000 patients and their families worldwide for arthritis, for support, education, advocacy, and now research as well.
If you have creaky joints, does that mean that you're on the verge of getting arthritis, or you have arthritis, or?
It's a good question. So I guess that goes to the question of what is exactly arthritis. There's actually many different forms of arthritis.
Sure.
The most common form is called osteoarthritis. And I suppose you might think of that as having creaky joints. It's a sort of deterioration that happens to many of us over time, where it's a wearing down of the joint and the cartilage there. But then there's also inflammatory forms of arthritis, things caused by synovitis, or when the synovial fluid, the lining in the joints, gets red, swollen, inflamed, hot. Things like rheumatoid arthritis, a lot of people know about, and that strikes more women than men, and actually can often hit people in the prime of their life, 35 to 55 years old.
I can hear Daily Dose FM. What do you think? So who do you serve? Who are some of the people? How did they get involved in this research of yours?
That's a great question. Yeah. So we really serve, and I personally serve the arthritis patients around the country and around the world. We're located right here in New York. Our office is in Nyack, Upper Nyack, so just north of the city. I'm a proud Harlem resident. I've been there about 10 years. So we serve, you know, people not only locally, but nationally and even internationally as well. And in particular, people who are living with these chronic conditions
Sure.
and their caregivers.
Is there a certain age where you begin to get arthritis or?
You know, it depends. So for people with the more inflammatory forms of arthritis, it can affect people even when they're children. For the most part, rheumatoid arthritis affects people in middle age. Osteoarthritis we think of as being more of an older person's disease. As we get older, our risk of getting osteoarthritis or OA goes up. And people can find out more about creaky joints by going to our website, to the creakyjoints.org, creakyjoints.org website. Or give us a call, give me a call,
sure.
And I'll tell you our phone number later.
Ben, is there some things that we can do in order to stem it or head it off or get ahead of the game there?
That's a great question. You know, in some ways people, it's counterintuitive. Some people think like, oh, I gotta slow down, I need to not do as much. And so they can be scared off by things like exercise. But there's a phrase in the arthritis community called motion is the lotion.
Ah.
So it seems counterintuitive, but actually movement, exercise, even jogging actually can improve symptoms for many types of arthritis.
Stretching,
absolutely.
Yeah. Lubricate those joints. Get moving.
but I think most importantly, people need to get in touch with their doctor, to talk to their primary care provider. Mm-hmm. If they have a rheumatologist, if they have an inflammatory form of arthritis,
yes.
to work closely with their doctor to make the decisions that make sense for their particular case.
Let's talk about the importance of the work that you do.
First
of all, how did you get involved in it, and why is it so important?
So my background is as a healthcare social worker. I was a medical social worker working in hospital with patients for many years. Mm-hmm. And working alongside doctors and working alongside patients in that kind of a healthcare setting, you see that actually patients bring so much wisdom to health, right?
Yeah.
To their own healthcare. They're really their own, you know, their own best doctor in many cases. And so when I got my PhD and started focusing in on research, in arthritis research in particular, I was really excited to be able to bring that kind of patient, clinician, or doctor relationship into the work that I do, into
sure.
the research work, because I think research is better when patients are involved, when patients are leaders and partners in designing research and getting the word out about research and
yeah.
understanding the results. And so the project that we're working on right now is called Better Said, and this is for joint replacement, actually hip and knee joint replacement.
Yeah.
And we believe that joint replacement research would be better said when patients are involved.
Yeah, they're involved, they've been through it, they know, and you could put those two, you could put the academic and the practical experience together. The
exactly.
practical experience from, you know, the patient having to go through it, and then all the things that you've learned through your research.
Exactly.
Yes.
That's right. Because patients have a lot of questions. They have decisions that they've had to make along the way, especially for something as big as a joint replacement, hip replacement or knee replacement. It's a big deal. You know,
it is.
You go under anesthesia. It takes a while to recover. There can be complications, and so you want to get some answers. You want to be well informed going in for those kinds of procedures.
Sure,
they
sure.
certainly help people, and I've talked to a lot of people who say, "I don't know why I didn't do this sooner. My life is so much better. I have more mobility
yeah.
and function."
A lot
now.
Of people go through it for years, thinking that the body will take over and it would heal itself. And sometimes it will in some cases, but you know, when enough is enough, you have to go and try to find out the necessary steps to take in order to get the job done.
That's right.
Operation, knee replacement, hip replacement.
Exactly. And there's a lot of questions that are a little bit mysterious or kind of behind the curtain for patients. For example, which particular device is being used? Because there's doctors have a choice, actually, of which particular knee or hip mechanics they use, the sort
oh,
of,
wow. yeah.
you know, the metal or the porcelain joint that goes, or the plastic joint that goes into the body. That's something that patients don't really ask about or think about,
yeah.
but it's something that they should be concerned with, because most of them work out great. Occasionally there are problems with the devices themselves. So we want patients to be informed. We want to get them engaged in asking those kinds of questions and being part of the research to study what does work best.
Sure, and I'm sure a patient wants to know, I want the best, you know, give me the Mercedes Benz or the Porsche. Give me something that, you know, if you take something out, put something in that's
absolutely
that works just as well or better.
That's right. And so those are the kinds of decisions that doctors often make. And sometimes they talk to the patient about it, but not all the time.
And finally, what advice would you give to people who are more or less suffering or have a squeaky joint or need a knee replacement?
Well, right now our project, we have a couple ways to get involved. So I mentioned creakyjoints.org. We have arthritispower.org, which is a research initiative. And then we have something called Better Set, roundtables that we'd like to invite people to come to in New York on Thursday, September 22nd. Mm-hmm. I hope they'll come, people who are candidates for joint replacement or who have had a hip or knee joint replacement. We need them. We need patients to come talk to us, come talk to doctors, and share their thoughts, what's important to them.
Ben, where can they go for more information on this?
So they can call us at 845-348-0400. Mm-hmm. They can also go to creakyjoints.org, to our website, or just Google Creaky Joints and Better Said, and it'll come up to the information page.
Give a big round of applause, everybody. Ben Noel, Director of Patient-Centered Research, Creaky Joints Centered Research for Global Healthy Living Foundation. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Bob.
Is there a number to call, by the way?
Yes.
Well, who can they call?
845-348-0400.
Say it one more time.
845-348-0400.
Thank you. I'm going to call you a doctor anyway, Doc. All right, we got to take a quick break, but stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Open next. Thanks, Doc.
Shoulders. Your shoulders is a three-tier muscle. You have your front delt, you have your rear delt, and you have your mid delt. So when you're working out your shoulders properly, you have to do three different exercises.
It's wonderful being able to compete with a lot of these young guys from all over the world. It's important to stay in shape.
I'm only 17, but I know about investing. Believe in something, buy shares in it, watch it grow. So, what if you could invest in the future? The future of kids, like a stock. Not the kind of stock that's about making money, but a stock for social change. A whole new kind of investment called Better Futures. When you invest, it helps kids go to college. I could be one of the first college graduates from my family, the first philanthropist from my neighborhood. And if I'm the first, then maybe there's a second and a third. Believe in us, invest in us, watch us grow.
My name is Sydney, and I'm your dividend.
Welcome back, everybody. You know, September the 17th, the Inner City Gun Violence Prevention Incorporation will host their first annual You Have the Power to Change Your Destiny conference. Joining us with the preview, we have Dr. Esther Henry. Rev, welcome to the show. You're no stranger to the show.
Thank you, Bob. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me back again. It's a pleasure to see you, to be here. I'm grateful.
You want to start us off with a quick prayer?
Sure.
Ten seconds.
Okay. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you right now for your son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for your mercy and your kindness and your goodness and your love. Father, speak wisdom and knowledge to us today, and we will always give you the glory and the honor. And God, we thank you for your salvation. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your understanding. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Rev.
Thank you.
Now, we said something off mic. Of course, your mm-hmm. son is a victim of gun violence.
Yes, Bob.
You mentioned that they had caught the person who did that.
Yes.
Tell us about it.
Yes. I found out November the 20, I believe it was on Thanksgiving Day. I don't remember the exact day on Thanksgiving Day this year. I received a phone call that the person that murdered my son was killed too. So, you know, there's no winning this situation.
Yeah.
And I really wanted that person to be alive so I can have a conversation with the person to let the person know, you know, I forgive you. And I wanted to know, why did you take my son's life and why did you want to live?
Yeah.
And that would have been my question to him. So
things come right back around.
You live by the sword, you die by the sword.
No,
he was murdered
in the neighborhood.
In the street. Matter of fact, he was murdered 10 days after my son's birthday, in the same month of my son's birthday.
This year?
My son, 2013.
Because your son was gunned down.
In 2012.
2012.
Right. So he was that next year he was murdered around my son's birthday. So my son's birthday is coming up September the 20th. So. Yeah.
And from that, you became an activist.
Very
not only a reverend, but you're out there with your sleeves rolled up. You go to funerals. You do a lot of things in our community. Tell us about it.
Yes, I am very active in the community. I do funerals. I go out on the street. I went to the White House. I received the President Obama Lifetime Achievement Award last year. And I went to like 500 events. Mm-hmm. And I'm out there, I'm a clergy liaison. I sit on Community Board 5. I do so much, and I do a lot, and I'm continue to do a lot until the day the Lord calls me home, because I know that my son's death will not go in vain, because I stand as the intercessor for him. And for many other children that are being daily murdered out there, I am the voice for the Bronx. I do a support group every third Wednesday at Lincoln Hospital. That's when my son passed away. That's where I'm at. People think it's crazy. You're there. I mean, we have mothers, we have fathers, we have aunts, uncle. It is phenomenal, the group that's coming together.
So what happens with that support group? People come there and what happens?
Mothers come, fathers. Every third Wednesday at Lincoln Hospital from 6 to 7:30, and those that has been a victim, their children by gun violence, they come there for the support, the love, the care, and they get that. And especially the newer mothers and fathers that come in, like a mother lost her son 4 months ago. She's our newest mother, and when she came in, she was very lot of despair, pain, crying, and we are older mothers. We are seasoned.
You guys have been through that. Yes.
Yeah, so we was able to hug her and grip her in and let her know that we care for you, we love you, we're here, and we're never tired of hearing the same story.
Do you meet up with the mothers that that meet with Hillary Clinton?
I haven't got a chance to do that. I'm hoping that will happen. I believe it's called the Mothers on the Move.
Yes.
And I haven't got to meet them, but I briefly met Hillary at some kind of function,
mm-hmm.
and I told her that my son was murdered in 2012, and you know, I stand with her coming against the NRA to put, I guess, stricter laws on these guns and stuff,
sure.
But and also sit on her campaign, but I would love to meet those mothers.
What would you like to see as far as eradicating guns from our communities, or helping to something in place to help stem that violence?
I would like to see more jobs, more mentorship programs, more studios, more dance studios, more music studios, more things to get our children involved, because like all the recreation centers has been closed, so they have nothing to do with their time. I would like to see those guns buried in a souk and a casket and put in the ground. I would like to see those illegal guns out of the hands of criminals. I would like to see computers in our youth hands, mm-hmm. cameras and things that would educate them and that will give them in the right way. And that is my goal, you know, just to get the right funding to do something in our community, because that's what I'm about, helping.
Yeah, my God. Do you have an event coming up?
Yes, I do, Bob. I have an event coming up September the 17th. Mm-hmm. And the reason why I picked September the 17th, because September the 20th is my son's birthday, and I wanted to celebrate him. I didn't want to be sad. I wanted to be happy. I wanted to keep his life moving. Yeah. And we're going to have a great event at the Bronx Museum of Art.
Oh, yeah. That's right off of the concourse, right?
Yes. This is our second time there. Uh-huh. And basically, we're going to gear towards our youth, our troubled youth. And we're going to have conversations with them, and they're going to have a conversation with us, and we also going to have our doctors come back and our mothers that lost their children and NYPD and all the entities, mm-hmm. because I believe when everyone comes together as one, then it can happen. You can't move this person from the equator to say, oh well, because he's a police, he shouldn't be here, or because that's the DA and we're gangs. No, we all need to come together. It's not about being a snitch. It's about making our community safer. And the question would be to me, how can we work together? How can our children put a little more trust in y'all?
Yeah.
You know, let's do this together as a family.
I always say that, you know, everybody moving together in the same direction for a common cause.
Yes.
Make it all happen.
Yes.
You know,
so
and Rev, you're in a position to put a lot of that stuff together.
Yes, I'm excited. I'm excited about this. I'm excited about our youth. I'm excited about our community. I'm excited about people. I love people, and I want to see change. I want to see our children grow to the fullness and everything that they have. These are our presidents and our doctors and lawyers. Mm-hmm. They shouldn't be in the grave.
That's right. All right, so who do you hope to reach? Who's going to come down to this event that you're doing?
Again, I'm hoping for, like, Guns Down, Life Up, SOS, Stop the Violence, Mother Harlem Save, NYPD, doctors from Lincoln Hospital that see children come in with gunshot wounds in their head, mentor, hoping even to see you, someone that can speak positive enforcement into their life. Some people that they will look up to, and you know, Dr. Bob Lee, everyone looks a lot, people look up to you and love you, and these are the key people that I'm gearing at to say, because sometimes they won't listen to a mother or father, but they'll listen to someone else, a leader. So, you know.
You have one of the flyers here?
Yes, I do. It's kind of...
All right, we'll get it. We'll get it.
Yes,
And FM will get some more information from you, too.
Okay, great.
All
right.
Where can we reach you for more information? You have a number or a website?
Yes, you could. I'm still in the process of setting a web page up, but you can reach me at 718-374-7487. You have my administrator. I don't have the number on hand, but I can get back to that.
That's okay.
It's on the flyer.
You took us in with a prayer, and I take us out with a quick prayer, creating a harmony between our communities, our police department, and everybody involved.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you right now that you spoke wisdom over this studio today. God, you said in your word, when two or three are gathered in your name, you said there you'll be in the midst, and we can ask anything in your name and it shall be done and will be established. Today I ask for world peace in our nation. I ask that all entities come together, NYPD, mothers, communities, clergies, lay members, everyone, so we can have a safer community and our children will grow to the fullness and we will have peace, love, and joy. And we need it. And we thank you for Dr. Bob Lee. Continue to bless him, continue to guide him and protect him and his staff. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Give the Rev a big round of applause, everybody. Reverend Dr. Esther Henry, activist. The Inner City Gun Violence Prevention Incorporation. Thank you so much.
Thank
for
you.
That.
Okay. All right. Amen.
God bless you. Stick around for
yes,
a second. We
I
have
will.
To take a quick break, but when we return, we'll take a look at our unique program filled with music, art, and more. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
We are neighbors and best friends.
I love my sister.
My heart doesn't see race. Love is love.
Our family is no less than any other family.
Love is kind. Love is patient.
They said I have troll teeth.
That my voice sounded like a possessed baby doll.
That no one would ever love someone as stupid as me.
That I was fat. Ugly.
Disgusting.
The effect of bullying is potent.
We will no longer be the silent majority.
Now, when you see online bullying, there's something you can do about it.
We're gonna take action with the eye.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness.
I am a witness, and so are you.
Hello, good people of the Bronx and beyond. Welcome to A Life in Art.
Good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you.
Hamilton was adopted from a rescue in 2008. He really likes to be around people. And as soon as I start to make my breakfast, Hamilton is right there. I get out my mat and I'm doing a downward dog and he's underneath. He's quite the pug about town. He gets invited to a lot of parties. He knows he's a pretty big deal. I mean, look at this little face. How could you not love him?
Hey, welcome back, everybody. I'm your host, Dr. Bob Lee. Our next guest is the CEO of LTJ Music Group and joins us today for a look at her work in the community. And we welcome LaToya Jones Herbert. Give her a big round of applause. And student Nasia. Nasia Bey is in the house. Yes, indeed. Give him a big round of applause, too. Yes. Tell us about some of the work that you do with the organization.
Well, I've had the opportunity to offer this music program in the South Bronx. I was actually working at the South Bronx Academy for Applied Media as a paraprofessional, and I was asked by the principal to introduce musical arts. It was very needed. Mm-hmm. It's definitely a program that's needed in the South Bronx specifically, because it's a lot of violence, it's a lot of things going on, and they needed something.
So the Rev was talking about that earlier. We need more things in our community to take people away from the violence.
Absolutely. So this program is definitely designed to do that. We use music to basically just refocus the youth and get them right on the right track, even if they're not trying to do music in the future. Something that will engage them.
Yeah. Now, Sia, you said you were the first one there, huh? When you heard about the program, you said, hey, that's where I need to go. Tell us about it. How'd you find out about it?
Well, she was working in the school's after-school program, and she was with my class, and we would do homework. And one day I saw her writing this paper, and I asked her what she was doing. And she said she is having a program for the musical arts. So I was like, okay, I rap. And she was like, okay, then you should go.
So you said you rap? You told her you rap?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So I said that, okay, I'll go to her program. So I went, and I rapped, and she helped me with that.
Was it a positive rap?
Absolutely. That's the only thing I allow.
You know. See? Yeah, all right. A quickie.
Quick, right now?
Yeah. Ready? Okay. One, a two, a one, two, three, four.
Okay. All right.
I'll do the beatbox.
No, this is
ready?
Mm-hmm.
Go.
Okay. I'll teach you how I flow, because I'm the educator. I'm serving up the kill, I'm the death excavator. Know what slash the terminator, because I'll terminate your style. I'll leave you hanging off the beat and have you stuck there for a while. I'll change the title of my file down the dial. I'll beat you in an instance. We don't even need a trial, but you're acting buck wild. You're a nuisance, but the end is full. Never mind, Deathstroke, just call me the Deadpool. I said that because, you know, the movie, it came out.
All right. So you heard that and you said, what?
Well, it didn't sound like that when I first heard.
It was different.
It was a little different?
Yeah.
Yes, he came in.
He has skills. Let's do this. Yeah. What did you do next?
You know what? Actually, it started out as poetry. I was challenging him in that area. Can you rhyme? Can you flow with a rhythm?
You see?
You know?
See? You heard what she said? You started out as poetry.
Yeah.
You know what? I was in your shoes 100 years ago. Not that long ago. I wrote a rap. For radio, it was the first rap that hit radio, and I gave it to this young man by the name of Frankie Crocker, and he read it on the air as a poem. He saw it the same way you saw it. Mm-hmm. It is poetry, mm-hmm. but I don't think they wanted to recognize rap at that particular time. It was so early. But my friends and I we were listening, and he said, well, we'll come right back, and we'll read Bobby Lee's rap from Queensbridge, you know. I mean, Bobby Lee's poem from Queen. Mm-hmm. We said, oh, wow, he thinks it's a poem. And he came back, and sure enough, he read it as a poem. And that's how you saw it, right?
Absolutely. Well, I told him, write me a poem. Uh-huh. And then I put it to a beat. And when he did it, he wasn't as fluent as he is now. Uh-huh. It was more like da-da-da-da-da, you know. But he's grown exponentially over a year, so I'm proud of him.
So you happy you got involved in this organization?
Yes, I'm very happy.
All right, so what do you want to see next? Where do you want to go?
I'm not even sure. I just, you know, she lets me know what I'm going to do. And most of the time, it's really awesome. Like, I get to perform places in colleges and stuff. And I get to come places like here.
Yeah.
This makes me really excited.
Come on TV, look at that. All right. On TV, woo. You're a big star now.
Mm-hmm.
I want to get your autograph before you leave, okay?
All right.
All right. Now, do they have to maintain any grade point average or anything like that?
Actually, I am very involved in their education because I want to make sure that whatever they're doing in the program is translating in the classroom.
Sure.
So I'm in contact with the teachers. I'm in contact with the parents. Uh-huh. Me and Nasir's mom are very close. We talk very often because I want to make sure that whatever he's gaining from the program is going into other areas in his life.
Mm-hmm.
So I've seen growth, not just with Nasir, but several of the students that have come into my program. When they come in, they have behavioral problems, they have low grade point averages. He's very smart, so that wasn't the case for him. He had little behavioral issues, but, you know, he has grown in that area. You know, he thinks before he acts, and all. It's awesome what music can do. Music is powerful.
Yes.
So I like to use that. He just actually had the opportunity to perform at a Guns Down Life Up event in Brooklyn, and it was amazing. You know, the crowd responded in such a way we weren't even expecting. As soon as he opened his mouth, everything just stopped.
See?
You know, but it's powerful, you know, and what he's saying is, let's stop, let's rise above what we're doing. So it's not like he's promoting the violence. He's saying, let's end the violence and do something different.
Yeah.
And he writes everything.
See that?
So he's amazing.
Putting the pen to the paper, that's a good start right there. Now, You got to get in touch with Rev.
Absolutely. Yes. I was listening. I was like,
right?
Oh, yeah, we got to make something happen.
Make a connection right
here.
Yeah,
I'm a youth pastor, too.
There you go.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah.
See, people moving together in the same direction for a common cause. We got to put that together. People moving together in the same direction for a common cause.
I like that.
Slow.
Bam. You got it? You in there? Don't steal my stuff.
You can
put it
in his next
rap. You can do a rap on it?
Maybe,
but make sure you throw my name in there with it, okay?
All right.
All right, so where do we go from here?
Well, I'm hoping that eventually we'll be able to have our own location, because right now we do it in the schools. And I did it for the first time in the summer, and I had it in my aunt's church. But I'm looking to have our own location so that people from all over, young people from all over can come and, you know, be a part of this program.
Asta?
Yes.
You got a connection?
Absolutely.
All right, maybe you guys can talk more. You came to the right place.
I know.
You're right on time.
I see.
All right. Is there anything that you would like to tell our public about our viewing audience about what you're doing or how you want to engage them?
Absolutely.
Yeah, use that camera right there.
I would suggest that you guys visit the yadp.org and just see how your kids can get involved. Music is very powerful, and what we do in this program is definitely engage them and encourage them to go forward in life. even if music is not something they want to attain, it's definitely something that will help them reach their goal. So look into the program and see if it's something that you would be interested in sending your kids to do, because I believe that it would be an awesome, awesome thing for them to do for their future.
Where can they contact you for more information?
They can go to the website, yadp.org, or they can email me at gmail.com.
Young Artists Perform. Let's do it.
Yeah.
You took us in with one, take us out with one.
Okay.
Now see ya, ladies and gentlemen, go.
All right. So I'm gonna do one, and she said for the poetry, mm-hmm. right, to a beat, I'm gonna do that one.
Okay, go ahead.
All right. I'm about to tell a story about my life, about my family and how I get light, share with people and make things right. I'm a new improved rapper, little narcissism tonight. I got a strong mental capacity, I'm filled with tenacity. I have no doubt that I can come up with a strategy to stay with my family and always be connected. My knowledge are not from hell, but they might be resurrected. I know they're perfected, I'm worn and selected. I know I'm the best because all the rappers have checked it. People ain't on me and my style. I know I just began, but I'm winning by a mile. I'm burning your file, I'm lyrically heated. My rhymes are nice, you can't wait for me to complete it. But listen up, I'm far from done. Let's take it back a couple of seconds. I killed it with verse one. I'm about to tell a story about my life, about my family and how I get light, share with people and make things right. I'm a new improved rapper, little nonsense on tonight.
I was cutting it up on the ones and twos over here. Give them a big round of applause, everybody. Nasia Bey. He's a student learning, and he's going to be helping out some other students, too. And LaToya Jones Herbert, LTJ Music Group. Thank you so much for coming
by.
Thank you
for having us.
And come by again, and good luck with everything.
Thank you so much.
Make sure you get with Rev, and she'll take good care of you.
Absolutely.
You guys will take good care of each other. We're going to take a quick break right here, but coming up next, we'll preview an exciting parade filled with entertainment, culture, and a whole lot more. Next, stay tuned. We'll be right back.
It's not always easy being a dad.
Do you have panda asthma too? Does that run in the family?
This is the home of the most priceless kung fu artifacts.
But when you make an effort...
Dad, we're not supposed to touch anything!
Oh, sorry. Go along, son!
It's always worth it.
Whoa! Master!
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
I am gonna get you. I'm gonna get you.
Call 877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov to learn more.
Morning, Gary. We are GetSchooled.com. You want a college education, don't you? Gary, financial aid forms.
Biology homework, G.
What? Picking a college, man. You and us go together like tacos and Tuesday.
And I love tacos.
Hi, this is Jeff Fox from 107.5 WBLS. And when I get off the radio, I check out my man, the Dr. Bob Lee. It's open on Bronxnet. I never miss it.
ShelterPetProject.org.
Hey, it's Ava, and this is Tess from Do Your Selfie, where we recreate the hottest looks from today's biggest music videos.
After cleaning out our closet, we have a lot of clothes we don't wear anymore.
Like this old pile of t-shirts.
It's not garbage, it's actually a new rug.
And to make it, all you need to do is cut, tie, and glue.
Cut the t-shirt into strips.
Tie the strips into knots.
And glue the knots to the bath mat. I love it. Give your garbage another life
and recycle.
And welcome back. Hey, check this out. On September the 18th, put that down on your calendar, September the 18th, the 47th annual African American Day Parade will return to Harlem. It's been doing it for, 47 years. And joining us with a preview, we have Yusef Hassan and Sinchana. Sinchana Elkerson.
Yes.
Sinchana. I got to remember Sinchana.
Right.
I'm not going to mess with that, but that's okay. I got you. So this is the 47th annual. Last year was extraordinary. Tell us about what's going to be happening this year.
Well, this year is our 47th, and it's going to be a great parade. We have some great, great grand marshals this year. As you know, we're honoring our educators. This year we have the president of Howard University, Dr. Wayne A. Fredericks. Mm-hmm. We also have Dr. Makula Abdullah from Virginia State University. And also we have Sabrina Lamb. She is the CEO of the Money Institute. Ann William Eisen, who is the CEO of the Harlem Children's Zone. Mm-hmm. And also we're gonna be happy to have Howard University Marching Band to lead our parade this year. So it's gonna be a great, great, great occasion for our community.
I gotta put that down, Lucy. Howard U is gonna be there. Mm-hmm. Now, let me just take you back just a little bit, because you've been there for years, and I've come on with the Hal Jackson doing a broadcast under a tent years ago.
And I remember.
All the dignitaries, all the elected officials used to stop by, and Hal Jackson used to put them on the air. And I was a guy that was just working the streets and everything. At the end of the parade, the Black
Federation of Cowboys.
The Federation of Cowboys used to come by with the horses, and one guy used to let me get on his horse, and that was the end of the parade.
Exactly.
Not ride the heck out of the horse around, but just move around and just wave and shake a hand. Sinjana.
Yes.
You do a lot with the organization. Tell us what you're putting out right about now.
Well, right now I'm the communications and PR director. Mm-hmm. So in terms of really just building our online presence for the African American Day Parade, it's been going on for so long, and obviously people in the community know about it, and people from other states who've participated in it. But to really get an online presence and really start to bring in a different generation into this parade has been a huge passion of mine.
So you're working on it now. Some people say, we've been having this, we've been doing it. People have been coming from Maryland, the Maryland Marching. Mm-hmm. Maryland comes by in a big way, right?
Yeah,
those
Baltimore,
big marching bands come through. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful. What do you have this year? You have any surprises?
Any surprises? Well, we have over 200 organizations participating, uh-huh. So that's a lot of surprises in itself. And we actually have organizations coming from Nigeria this year.
Wow,
yes.
Look at that. All right.
So, they'll be traveling here, and they just really want to come in, do something cultural, and celebrate, African-American heritage.
When you said do something cultural, I just visualized the culture of Africa,
yes,
and the nice African garb and the different colors, mm-hmm, and the fabrics that they wear coming, mm-hmm, up the avenue there.
Yep.
Beautiful.
Exactly.
And one thing about the African American Day Parade, it's like no other parade in the city of New York. Mm-hmm. It's a national parade, and we make sure that we showcase the best of our communities.
Yeah.
It's important that we realize how so many things have gone on throughout generations, and we forget about contribution of the African Americans here in America. And that's our focus. We focus on the ancestors, we focus on the best in our community, because we have some great people in the community that are still doing wonderful, great things.
Yes, yes.
Especially our local unions and our organizations who've been out front trying to keep the dignity and the honor of our community and peoples alive. This is what this parade is really, mm-hmm, about. Years ago we used to have these alcohol floats and beer floats and all these negative things in the parade. We've decided that that's not going to be a part of the African parade, mm-hmm, going forward. We want to get rid of those beer floats or negative advertisement, and we've done that.
Yeah.
And I think that's going to be important going forward.
I see we have the fraternities, sororities, we have all the city workers, mm-hmm, we have the Masons, we have the female Masons,
Eastern Stars. Yes.
We have. Did I say the fire department, police department,
no, court, all civil servants?
Yeah. So all the civil servants, they come by with their brand new trucks and brand new police, mm-hmm, cars and all that stuff. So it's a big, colorful parade. How can somebody get involved in it if they want to, say, hey, you know what, I would like to put a float in there or get more involved in the African American Day Parade?
Well, they can visit our website, www.africanamericandayparade.org. Mm-hmm. And they can go to the Get Involved tab, and they can have, all the information about participation is on there, all the information about purchasing a float is on there, even getting a journal ad. We do an annual journal in which you can put your ad in the journal, and it gets circulated throughout the entire parade route. And did I mention there's over 900,000 people on the parade route?
Not only that, they get put on the website.
And they get.
I'm just adding that. I don't know. Yes.
Absolutely. Yes. And on our social media as well.
Yes. Yes.
So we're always looking for different people who want to participate and advertise in the parade. Mm-hmm.
And we're also looking for volunteers, especially from our colleges and universities, to help us make sure this parade is really, really hosted properly mm-hmm. and organized well. You know, we've had quite a few people tell us, why do we not take this parade down on Fifth Avenue like other big parades are? Well, my thing is that we want to make sure that our senior citizens, our children, have a wonderful occasion on that day to come out and enjoy the parade at the reviewing stand, especially our seniors. And then we also want to make sure the economic stays in the Harlem community.
Yeah.
So this is important for me, and I know it's important for the board of directors. And we are grateful for you for many years of out on the ground, keeping the people moving and keeping this enthusiasm mm-hmm. alive. So we really appreciate the work that has been going on with African American Day Parade and going forward.
Yes.
We want to make sure that people realize how important it is.
103 is going to be there. WBLS is going to be there. Mm-hmm. We'll probably get Bronxnet up there. How has it grown over the years? Tell us about it.
Well, it's grown expeditiously. You should see the difference in what it was 10 years ago to where it is today. Mm-hmm. Once we've gotten out of the negativity of the parade, where it went into the dark late at night, you know, sometimes 10, 11 o'clock at night, and people was drinking out in the parade route, we eliminated all of those things so that we wouldn't go into the dark. So now the parade is over at 6 o'clock in the evening. And this is a great change because at night, you know, other things begin to happen. And we have not had an incident in African American Day Parade in all the years I've been working on this parade, which is mm-hmm. 38 years now. We have never had anyone shot, killed in the line of march of African American Day mm-hmm. Parade. That's very important for people to know that.
Yeah.
And also we have the wheelchair charities where we have a whole contingency
Hank
of
Carter with the wheelchair charity.
Yes, with all the people in wheelchairs. Now, you know, they can come out in wheelchairs and march in the parade. What is it for us to have some of the best of our bands and local communities to come out and participate in this parade?
Where can we go for more information?
We can go to our website, which I mentioned, www.africanamericandayparade.com and .org, mm-hmm. as well as our social media, hashtag AADPINC. That's for our Twitter, our Facebook, as well as our Instagram.
Mm-hmm. Give them a big hand. Sinchana Elkerson, Communications and PR Director, African American Day Parade. Youssef Hassan, Chairman, African American Day Parade. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
Got to take a quick break right here. Stay tuned. We'll be right back with more Open next.
Thank you so much.
Every Monday night at 9, we talk to the borough's movers and shakers about the latest in Bronx politics, education, healthcare, arts and culture, and literally any and everything that's important to the people of the Bronx. There's a reason why Bronxites have been turning to Bronx Talk for more than 20 years, because Bronx Talk is about you and me, the people of the Bronx. So we'll see you Monday night at 9.
There's a shelter pet who wants to meet you. Meet one today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org. Adopt.
Hey, did you know 2.4 million loving cats and dogs in shelters and rescues need our help to find a home? Let's go to theshelterpetproject.org and meet a few who are in a shelter near you. Harlow. Oh, she's one great listener who loves to hear all your stories. My kind of cat. Cerulo. Is a sweet, goofy boy who's eager to please. Sounds just like another dog I know. So go to theshelterpetproject.org, search your local shelters and rescues, and go for a cuddle with your next best friend. Adopt.
It's not always easy being a dad.
Do you have panda asthma too? Does that run in the family?
This is the home of the most priceless kung fu artifacts.
But when you make an effort...
Dad, we're not supposed to touch anything.
Oh, sorry. Go along, son!
It's always worth it.
Whoa, faster!
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
I am gonna get you. I'm gonna get you.
Call 877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov to learn more.
Thank you.
I'm David Lesh, legal correspondent to the morning show Open. If you have a legal question that you'd like me to answer, please send me an email at davidlesh@bronxnet.org, and I will address it on our Ask Your Lawyer segment.
Welcome back. Our next guest is the founding principal of the Mosaic Preparatory Academy. She joins us for a look at her work and upcoming events. We welcome Lisette Caesar to the show.
Good morning, Bob.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Good morning. Thank you for having me here.
So you have something very, very special coming up for the start of the school season. But before that, tell us about what you do.
Well, I'm the founding principal of Mosaic Preparatory Academy in East Harlem, District 4. We opened July 1st, 2008, so we're going into our ninth year as a New York City public school. Mm-hmm. We're the very first public school that's a college prep school, so we're very excited about that.
Great, great.
And we're also the very first bucket-filling school in New York City.
So with the what filling?
Bucket filling.
Bucket, tell us about it.
So bucket filling means that you do things for other people just because of the intrinsic value, not because you're getting anything out of it, just because you're making the other person feel good. So we teach those values to our students each and every day.
Excellent. I like it.
Thank you.
Thank you. So you have something coming up September the 1st.
We have a back-to-school jam at 10 a.m. in our big schoolyard. We have a humongous schoolyard. It's a soccer field, and we have lots of people coming out. Mm-hmm. We have the Bullion Foundation bringing artists. So we're going to be giving...
I know about that foundation. Who's the young lady that runs that foundation again?
Sandra Trim DaCosta, a very good friend to Mosaic Preparatory Academy. We have a great partnership with them. We are giving out book bags to all the scholars that go to our school, 350 book bags we plan to give out that day. We have the health department there doing health screenings, dental work. We also have some exercise equipment going to be there. We're going to have the Mighty Milers, Super Soccer Stars will be there doing some activities, so it's going to be a really fun day. All my teachers will be there, the staff will be there doing face painting. Some of my teachers will be doing double dutch with the kids, so it's going to be a great day.
And this school is located in Brooklyn?
It's in Harlem.
In Harlem.
East Harlem.
Okay.
141 East 111th Street between Lexington and Park.
All right, not too far from where we are today. What's so unique about this particular school?
Well, you know what's different about us is that we make sure that we know every single child. To the point that we know the family, I do home visits personally, I go out into the community, I know the store owners, so we really get to know everyone in the community, inside and out, and so that we're not just educating the kids in terms of academics, but we're trying to build a community where we also know what's happening with them socially, economically, to make their lives better.
Yeah, and that's important because parents that walk closely with their students, usually students become more successful, and the parents get a chance to learn also.
Right. And we have a large parent component.
It's like the parents are going back to school.
Because we do a lot of parent workshops at the school. We have a lot of parent workshops on September 1st. We'll have workshops in the building for parents in terms of health. I also do a lot of parent workshops. I'm a diabetic, so I do a lot of workshops around diabetes for my parents. Sure. I actually have a walking group every Wednesday with Girl Trek, so I walk with my parents around Hollemere, which is close to the school. We'll also have Shape Up New York for the parents. So we do a lot of activities, not just for students, but also for the parents. Like I said, it's a community school.
How'd you get involved in it? Did you always want to do this?
In elementary school, I said to my mom I was going to be a teacher. And so ever since then, it's been like, I say it's a Christ calling, that I was called to do this work. I kind of veered off a little while when I dropped out of college from Baruch for 2 years, but then God called me back to this work, and here I am going into my 22nd year in education.
You see what happens when you put something in your mind?
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you want to do something, God gives you all the ammunition that you need to make it all happen.
He surely did. It wasn't easy. It definitely had obstacles. I come from a mother of Dominican background. She came here to this country with very little means, and she was a single parent of three children, but she made sure all of her three children are college educated. But also, I have a lot of people that help me. I have my sorority, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. All my sorority sisters came
out. How do you do
the... Ski-wee!
Ski-wee.
So I had a fundraiser at my house over the weekend. My sorority sisters, my family, my friends all came and donated school supplies. We raised over 50 backpacks for the kids, 300 notebooks, 200 folders, pens and papers, paper galore. So everybody, it is a community from friends and family.
Are you still looking for more?
We are still looking for more. I need 60 more backpacks before September 1st.
I have something for you.
Okay, that's great.
I have a camera. Go for it.
So Mosaic Preparatory Academy in East Harlem, New York, we are still in need of 60 backpacks, so we hope that you'll donate. You can call me at 212-722-3109 or email me at lcaesar@schools.nyc.gov. We're also on social media, on Facebook, Mosaic Preparatory Academy, as well as on Twitter.
Is there a message you would like to send to the students or the parents?
Well, I send a robocall out every single Friday reminding them that they have to read and they have to do homework, they have to keep up their academic skills. So summer is not a time off, it's actually a time on to build your knowledge. Mm-hmm. So I wanna make sure that parents understand that we can still do work even though we're not in school. And I actually check, a couple of parents have been taking pictures of book reports and I've been grading them and sending back my responses to the kids directly.
Any message you would like to send to the parents or students about when they return to school and how they should conduct themselves throughout the school year?
I just want to remind everyone that we're a bucket filling school, so we make sure that we show love to everyone, and that goes for everyone. And make sure they're in full uniform. White top, gray bottom, black shoes, every day.
Ah, all right. And they have a place where they can go to get that, right?
They do have a place.
Discounts?
They
mentioned the school?
In the community, there's Regine's, and there's other stores like Target, those kind of stores, but also we do have some supplies in the school as well, in terms of uniforms.
Now, some parents may be watching this and say, you know what, I want to send my kids to a school like that. Okay. What do they have to do?
They can reach out to me. They can email me at lcaesar@schools.nyc.gov. A lot of parents have been emailing me through Facebook. They found me, my personal account on Facebook, which is Lisette Caesar. They can also, I'm doing tours today at 1 o'clock. I actually have some people meeting me at 1 o'clock today at the school for a tour.
Oh, look at that.
I am doing some tours tomorrow, and then we'll actually be on vacation for a little bit of over a week. And then we'll be back August 29th and tours all day long again.
All right. Give her a big hand, everybody. Lisette Caesar, founding principal, Mosaic Preparatory Academy.
Thank you.
In Harlem. Thank you so much for coming by, okay?
You're welcome. Thank
you. And we're going to pay a visit to your school. Don't go anywhere.
September 1st. You're going to be there, right?
Yeah. We're going to try
you're
our best.
You're going to be there.
There you go. That's how you say it.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, that's all the time we have for today's show. I'd like to thank all of our guests for joining us and you, our viewer, for tuning in and checking it all out. If you missed any part of today's show, well, you can tune into the recablecast of Open at 5 and 10 p.m., or you can watch anytime on the web at bronxnet.org, or you can catch an all-new episode Wednesday at 10 a.m. with our host, Darren Hyme. For all of us here at Bronxnet, thank you. Have a safe and enjoyable day. Helen, our producer, give her a big round of applause. Helen, thank you. And the whole crew working back there behind the scenes, our camera people, floor manager, thank you. Our telly person, and our floor manager, thank you so much. Remember this, what you are is God's gift to you, and what you make of yourself is your gift to God. So choose your choice and let your choice control the chooser. I'm the Dr. Bob Lee, and I'll catch you on the radio right after the quiet storm tonight on 107.5 WBLS. Peace. I